So we're back once again in Locarno. I'm James Latimer. I have the, as always, radiant Beatrice Bean next to me.
I like her.
And we're, it's about 7 o'clock in the evening. We've spent the entire day in the cinema. We're both somewhat tired, but that's normal. We're ready for that. And we're going to talk about a few more films that we've seen. I just came out of the screening of a Swiss competition film called La Brie by Fernand Melga, which, frankly, based on the quality of documentary shown here in competition over the last years, quite frankly, doesn't cut the mustard. It's a super basic TV-style documentary about a homeless shelter in Lausanne. Obviously a very important theme, obviously in Switzerland, something that needs to be talked about. Whether anyone internationally will be in any way interested by this film, I would expect to differ. But I'm sure Beatrice is maybe, hopefully, more than
I am. Actually, I didn't, because I also watched a documentary which was also more like mediocre TV stuff. Called Yalom's Cure. It's made by a Swiss woman called Sabine Giesinger, so I'm guessing this is why it's being shown here. Well, it's about this psychotherapist, some old guy in his 80s who lives in the United States, and he's a existential psychotherapist, and he has written a lot of books that a lot of 40 plus women, I guess, would like to read and think about themselves and their lives and stuff. And apart from that, it was it would be amazing on TV if nothing else is on, and you know, you're at home with like your popcorn and your pajamas. Good film. I'm not really sure why I'm watching this at Locarno. I really didn't understand. And it's like, it's really mediocre, and it's made like, you know, you have the talking heads and you have a couple of pictures where you can like think about your life because nothing happens, because you are just looking at the sea and there's a boat passing by very slowly.
Oh, wow.
And awesome. Yeah, I watched that at 9 a.m. in the morning. It was great. But you saw something else which was good.
I actually saw something really, really good.
Thank God, I mean, somebody did.
I know, it's awesome. No, because I mean, basically, after the competition started incredibly strongly with Lav Diaz and Matisse Pinheiro, most of the things I've seen since then have been kind of disappointing. So I kind of basically did a bit of an outing to the new sidebar in Locarno. It's called Signs of Life. And the idea is to show cinematic frontiers, as it were. And the film I shot.
What does that mean?
I mean, it basically films which don't fit in anywhere else. I mean, films which are maybe a bit more experimental, which okay. maybe try and do new things. I mean, the New Frontiers thing is what I took from the
program. But isn't that supposed to be what's like shown in the whole Locarno? Why do they have a little side set? Okay,
maybe,
no, never
maybe
mind.
We're getting
never
a little
mind.
Bit off topic.
I'm sorry.
Anyway,
give me the film.
But the film is called Fort Buchanan, or Fort Buchanan, because it's actually a French film made by an American who's been resident in France for the last 10 years. And the director's name is, because I can never remember these things, Benjamin Crotty. And it's a film about a camp called Fort Buchanan. It's like an army camp where all the soldiers have gone away and the wives are hanging around basically waiting for their husbands to come back. Most of the wives, I mean, there are wives, but there are also husbands. And the main character is a guy who's been married to his army husband for the last 18 years. They have a daughter together who's just turned 18 and is very buxom. And basically, the first half of the film shows all of them hanging around in the woods, being very sexually frustrated. And it's revealed that the wives have lesbian sex with one another to pass
well,
the time.
What else are you going to do?
I mean, I know. I mean, I do the same. And basically, it has an atmosphere not dissimilar to the castle anthrax scene from Monty Python and the life of and the Holy Grail, which is obviously awesome. But it also, I mean, it kind of puts forward a vision of a kind of society that's entirely queer and entirely happy with that, even though actually there's a gay man who's been battered by his gay husband. So I mean, everything is not perfect in this utopia. But basically, gradually, the husband eventually goes to Djibouti to fight to win back his husband, who's grown less attractive to him over time. But mainly the film is just lots of funny dialogues, lots of vaguely slapstick comedy, also sight gags, all of which are incredibly well done. But at the same time, it's shot in 16mm with a great, great eye for details, with a great eye for colours. And in general, towards the end, it begins to wander off in a different direction, as if he got maybe bored of the relatively conventional plot he picks. But for me, it was the most unique thing I've seen here thus far. I mean, it kind of feels like a weird mix of this sort of French hybrid mumblecore Monty Python queer utopian comedy. comedy or something.
Okay, I want to see this
one. Yeah, you totally should. It's
awesome. You totally sold that.
No, it's really good.
Really
it
good.
Is really good.
You should
yeah.
be like a PR person.
I know, I totally love, you know, I have to stuff, whatever. So basically my faith in cinema was restored.
Thank God.
I slept really well, and that's a good thing. So Beatrice is going to go off and see that as soon as she possibly can. We're going to now relax into the evening. We'll possibly see a few more films, and we'll get back to you over the next couple of days, probably tomorrow. Thank you.
Bye.